morning students. Today's class we are going to discuss about the characteristics of underdeveloped country. You all know that we have a three classification: economically advanced nations or developed countries, economically developing countries, and low developed countries or less developed countries, and underdeveloped countries. So these are the three classifications. Based on this only we can say that whether a country is economically developed or not. Okay, so on the basis of calories intaken we can measure the development. Suppose here in the village areas they are supposed to take 2400 calories. In the towns and cities they are supposed to take 2100 calories. The person want to take below this recommended quantity means okay, they are all living below the poverty line. These countries are known as what? Economically underdeveloped countries are less developed countries. Let us discuss in detail about what are the causes of the underdeveloped country. First one, per capita income. How do we get our per capita income? So national income divided by total population means we will get the concept of per capita income. When we see the per capita income is the real measure of economic development. The per capita income is very low. So here we can say that a country is economically underdeveloped one. Per capita income means what? The income earned by individual. The person who earn 32 rupees per day means they are all considered as they are living above the poverty line. The person want to earn below this amount, they are all considered as that is below the poverty line. So here this is known as what? Low per capita income. Economic inequalities. In our countries only we will see the wide difference between the rich and poor. So there is a wide gap between have and have nots. Rich people are sleeping in the platforms and poor rich people are sleeping in the AC rooms and poor people are sleeping in the platforms. So in our country only we can find the world millionaires and the world paupers. So this is the inequality. So major economic wealth is concentrated only in the hands of the rich people, not in the hands of the poor people. 80% of wealth possess only by the 20% of the richest one, and that is the 80% of the people possess only a 20% of economic wealth. So there is a wide gap between that is here rich and poor. This is the inequality between rich and poor is the major cause for underdeveloped country. Next one, a low standard of living. The person one who should have maintained the better standard of living. So then only we can say that a person is in, that is enjoying the better standard of living. Almost all the people are that is here living only the low standard of they could not take the proper balanced diet. So they are affected by the so many diseases. This is called as what? A low level of living. Next one, too much of population depends on agriculture. When we see the income from the agriculture sector is not sufficient to maintain the better standard of living or a proper standard of living. The income is very low, but unfortunately a major percentage of the population depends on agricultural sector because there is no other way, there is no other go. So they have to earn a low income. So within that income they could not maintain the better standard of living or a proper standard of living. Next one here, low growth rate of per capita income. Already I told you the national income divided by the total size of population is called as what? Per capita income. Per capita income is very low. Population is a major constraint. So China ranks first in the population, India ranks second in the population. China is known as what? Most industrialized advanced one, but our country is not industrially developed one. So the population growth is ever growing one, ever increasing one, explosive one. So the entire income goes for only meeting out the needs of growing population. We could not concentrate on the development of industry. We could not concentrate on the development of service sector. So this is the population growth is the major constraint or a major bottleneck of Indian economy. Next one, foreign trade. Most probably we are importing each and everything from other countries. So if we import from the other countries, when we import anything from the foreign countries, major of our Indian currency goes in the hands of the foreign, that is here, investors. This may not be a good sign of economic development. When we promote the exports, mean it can boost up the economic development. But unfortunately, we are importing most of the items only from the other countries. This is known as what? Dependence on the foreign trade or foreign imports. Next one, vicious circle of poverty. When we see the vicious circle of poverty, we start from the consumption, low consumption, low savings, low investment, and low income, low production, low employment. So everything is low means this is known as what? Vicious circle of poverty. Unemployment is a very serious issue or a major serious issue of the Indian economy. Most of the people are unemployed. When we compare the rate between the educated unemployed and uneducated unemployed, educated unemployed rate is very high because the government could not provide the employment opportunities even though they have completed PhD, MBA, MC or a professional degree. So unemployment or underemployment is a very serious issue of our country. Capital, we are always facing the problem of capital. So inadequate capital may, that is, retard the economic development. If we have enough of capital means we can ensure the economic development, but unfortunately we are facing the shortage of finance, or that is, the shortage of capital means it may retard the economic development. Next one, backward technology we are following. When we adopt the foreign technology or latest technology means we can maximize the production, but unfortunately we are following only the traditional methods of technology. So this may be the cause of economic underdevelopment. Last one is the backward industrial structure. Industrially we are not very much developed because we could not start a major industry because of what? Low amount of finance and the inadequate finance. So that's why in the sense we cannot attain the concept of industrial development. So these are all the major causes of underdeveloped country. When we overcome these bottlenecks, in the sense we can ensure our economic development, we can make our country to travel in the path of economic progress. Already I told you the classification: underdeveloped countries, developed countries and less developed countries. Next slide. Underdeveloped economy, most of the countries are underdeveloped country, most of the African countries are underdeveloped countries. India is known as a developing one. Already we have studied the economic causes, social causes, political causes, cultural factors, technological factors. These are the major reason for the underdeveloped country. Already we have discussed in detail. So need of economic development, when we overcome all these bottlenecks, when we overcome all these, that is, problems, we can make our country to travel in the path of economic progress. So our country, that is, can travel from the stage of developing nation to the developed countries when we overcome all these factors. Economic determinants, so structural changes, a labor, we should improve the quality of the human resources and size of the labor, capital formation, capital output ratio. When we, that is, improve all these things, we can ensure the economic development. Vicious circle of poverty, already I told you, everything is extremely low. So that's why in the sense here, this is known as what? Vicious circle of poverty.